Hey, what's going on, guys? The Horror Man back on Slashback Saturday. This week's Slashback Challenge theme was game slashers. I challenged everyone to watch and review a slasher film that had something to do with games. The movie I watched is pretty obscure for general audiences, but it's very popular for VHS collectors, because this movie has not been released on DVD or Blu-ray in the US. It's also a tape that's highly sought after by VHS collectors, which is why they tend to know the film. In addition, it was written and directed by Nick Castle. Yes, the same Nick Castle who played the original Michael Myers, or The Shape, in John Carpenter's Halloween. I watched Tag, The Assassination Game. Tag, The Assassination Game is a 1982 slasher film starring a very young Linda Hamilton. This was before The Terminator, and I have to say, this is probably the best I've ever seen her look. It also stars a young Robert Carradine, Bruce Abbott, Christine DeBelle, and Xander Berkeley. Tag, The Assassination Game revolves around exactly that, a game of tag, played on a college campus. It's literally an extracurricular activity for which students sign up. There's football, track, the swim team, and tag, among others. The coordinator of this particular activity is named Nick Carpenter in the movie, which is obviously a nice nod to John Carpenter. Those who sign up for the game of tag are given dart guns with suction cup darts. Special victim files are also created for each of the players. The object of the game is to be the last player standing by eliminating the rest of the competition by shooting them with darts. Each player carries around an envelope with their intended next victim, and if they are eliminated, they must hand it off to the person who shot them. There are, of course, other rules as well, such as certain time frames when the game takes place and certain time frames when it doesn't. So you can't just walk into someone's classroom and shoot them. That's not how it works. After hours, though, when the game begins, it's an all-out war throughout the campus. And believe me, watching it is probably almost as fun as playing it, because this movie is a blast. But wait, you might be wondering, how is it a slasher film? Well, this is by no means a spoiler, because it happens very early on in the film, but Bruce Abbott's character is undefeated in the game of tag. He's won 5 straight times. When he is eliminated under bizarre and what he considers to be unfair circumstances, he becomes a sore loser, and he also loses his mind. He decides to finish the game in a different way, by going on a killing spree. He targets each of the remaining players, killing them off one by one. Meanwhile, Linda Hamilton's character is still in the game, and she's determined to win. A campus reporter, played by Robert Carradine, developed a crush on her when she hid in his room during one of the late-night battles. And so he decides to write an article on the game, using that as an excuse to get close to her. He requests that he be able to follow her around during the game, and she agrees. But when the student players begin turning up missing, it becomes a much bigger story than he ever imagined. The potential couple soon realizes it's not just a game of tag anymore. It's the assassination game, and they just might be the next victims. Guys, this movie is so awesome. Seriously, I love it. I remember watching this years and years ago on HBO. It was one of those movies that would get played quite often. I cannot for the life of me understand why this hasn't received a DVD or Blu-ray release. It's just tragic. It's sort of a tame college comedy meets slasher film, and it works so well. I should also mention that I really like the direction. I think Nick Castle did a fantastic job. The acting is also top-notch, especially with a cast like this. There is some blood, but not too much gore. And it's also probably worth mentioning that it's rated PG. The movie is super fast-paced, and it has a great ending. I highly, highly recommend this one, guys. It's so much fun. And what a concept. One that could never be used today. Think about it. Tag the Assassination Game is definitely an underrated 80s slasher, and as I'm sure we all agree, the 80s was the best decade for slasher films. It also happens to be the next theme for the Top 20 for 2020 that Jason and I created. On Friday, January 31st, we will be uploading our Top 20 favorite 80s slasher films. So, I thought to myself, why not? This week's Slashback Challenge theme is 80s slashers. I mean, come on. This was one of the most popular themes last year. Obviously, I was going to bring it back for Slashback the sequel. And by making it this week's theme, it gives everyone the opportunity to watch an 80s slasher that maybe you were considering including in your top 20. Maybe it's one you've seen before and you're sort of on the fence about it. You know, did it quite make the top 20 or not? Maybe it's a first-time watch that just might make it into your top 20, surprisingly, because it's just that awesome. Or maybe it's a movie you have already decided you will be including in your top 20, and you just want to revisit it. It's up to you. It just has to be a slasher film released in the 80s. So get watching and get reviewing 80s Slashers. And be sure to upload your video on Slashback Saturday. I will also be back on Saturday with a new review and reveal of a new theme in the Horror Man's Slashback Challenge. Thanks for watching, guys. Be kind. Subscribe. Oh, give me a shout. Oh.